The Oh My God particle is one of the most amusing names scientists have encountered in the physics field. One of the first things that may come to your mind when you hear this name is the Higgs boson, which was discovered in 2012. This isn't too surprising, as it was dubbed the God particle by the media. But these two particles are vastly different. The Oh My God particle has such a strange and godly nature that scientists couldn't resist naming it Oh My God. So, what is the Oh My God particle? It is an ultra-high energy cosmic ray detected on October 15, 1991 by the Fly's Eye camera in Dugway Proving Ground, Utah, U.S. It was the highest energy cosmic ray that had ever been observed at the time. Although higher energy cosmic rays have since been detected, the energy of this particle was unexpected, calling into question the origin and transmission of cosmic rays at that time. Since its discovery, scientists have been baffled by the Oh My God particle, a form of cosmic ray mainly protons, hydrogen nuclei, a single atomic nucleus moving at 99.99% the speed of light, smashed through Earth's atmosphere and flashed across the Utah sky. The nucleus shattered into a shower of subatomic particles and lights in a matter of seconds. The light was detected by the Fly's Eye Observatory, a collection of oversized tin cans used by the University of Utah as part of an early experiment to detect high-energy cosmic rays in the universe. According to scientists examining the data from Fly's Eye, the cosmic ray responsible for this specific flash must have had a kinetic energy of 3 times 10 to the 20th electron volts, EV. That's 48 joules, a unit of energy that we identify with macroscopic objects rather than subatomic ones. That single atomic nucleus has the same amount of kinetic energy as a large stone thrown at you at 50 miles per hour. The particle was dubbed Oh My God. Scientists had never seen anything like it before. In fact, such high-energy cosmic rays were thought to be non-existent. Most cosmic ray particles are mainly single protons, the nuclei of hydrogen atoms, and a small number of helium nuclei. However, roughly 1% of cosmic rays have heavier nuclei, as heavy as iron. Gamma rays and even antimatter particles come in at energies ranging from a few billion electron volts at the low end to a mind-boggling 10 to the 20th electron volts or greater, such as the Oh My God particle. The higher the energy, the rarer the particles are. The universe flings one particle every second per square meter of the Earth's surface at the lowest energies. They are scarce at energies close to those of the Oh My God particle. Since the first one, just a few have been discovered, giving a rare estimate of one per square kilometer every couple of centuries. Most cosmic ray particles now have low energy, up to 10 to the 10th electron volts, and are generated locally by solar flares. Another more energetic class, with energies up to 10 to the 15th electron volts, is thought to come from somewhere else in the galaxy. It's difficult to determine their specific source, as the magnetic fields of the galaxy and the solar system affect their trajectories. So they end up with a uniform distribution in the sky, as if they come from everywhere. However, these galactic cosmic rays are most likely the result of supernovae. Maybe in a delayed release process as particles bounce back and forth in the supernova remnant's magnetic field before being launched out into the wider galaxy. Then there are extragalactic cosmic rays of the Oh My God type, with energies exceeding 10 to the 15th electron volts and even reaching 10 to the 20th electron volts on rare occasions. They are formally known as ultra-high-energy cosmic rays. These particles travel at near-light speeds and must have had a lot of energy to achieve such speeds. However, the origin of extragalactic cosmic rays has long been shrouded in an exaggerated atmosphere of mystery. is reflected by the Oh My God title. Cosmic ray astronomy is becoming a more potent tool for understanding our fascinating world as we learn more about its origins. However, these particles are still useful today. The highest energy cosmic rays, such as the Oh My God particle, produce significantly more energetic collisions than our largest particle accelerator, the Large Hadron Collider. More research on cosmic rays could reveal the mysteries of both the largest and tiniest scales of space-time. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.